There's something to you. Well, you know that don't let nobody tell you different, that they love you.
Let's go. Brand new Lamborghini, a cop car. With a pistol on my hip like I'm a cop. Have you ever met a real new rock star? This ain't no guitar, but this a clock. My clock told me to promise you gon' squeeze me. You better let me go the day you need me. So put me on that and get the bus. Yeah, and if I ain't enough, I'll get the top. Keep a when I ride in the Suburban. It's a codeine, had a young swerving. I got the mop, watch me watch him like detergent. And I'm ballin', that's why it's diamonds on my shirt. Slide on outside and flip the block back, yeah, yeah. My junior popped him and left him lopsided, yeah, yeah. We spin his block, got the rebound in his ramen. For me one time, you can't cross me again. 1200 horsepower, I get lost in the wind. If he talking on it, y'all depend, dolls will take his chin. Maybach SUV for my refugee. 5 blocks in the hood, put money in the streets. I was solo when the ops called me at the gas station. Had it on me 30,000, thought it was my last day. But they ain't even want no smoke. If I had to choose it, murder would she roll?
Let's go. Brand new Lamborghini, the cop. Still on my hip like I'm a cop. Have you ever met a real new rock star? This ain't no guitar, but this a clock. My Glock told me to promise you gon' squeeze me. You better let me go the day you need me. So put me on that and get the bus. And if I ain't enough, I'll get the chop.
We are black people and we shouldn't have to feel like this. We shouldn't have to protest because y'all are treating us wrong. We do this because we need to. It's a shame that our fathers and mothers are killed and we can't even see them anymore.
On behalf of Larry and Veronica and James and Natasha and Marianne and all the Briggs family, just want to extend their gratitude for everyone here, being here today. A very difficult day, no doubt for the family, but your presence being here certainly helps. Also, they just all want to also extend their gratitude to so many people that have, you know, that have helped out in such a period of time over the last few weeks, and that particularly all the support that they've had. So on behalf of the family, just want to thank you. You know, being here means a lot to them. We're here today to farewell Mark, his journey home. We're also here to remember Mark and how his life touched each one of you today, that are here today. You know, we look at the booklets and so beautifully done. I love them because and as we look through them, they tell a story. The story of Mark's life. Pictures of loved ones and family. Pictures that remind us of Mark's life. This is time when we need to gather around one another and show our support for the family and one another. And I just want to say to the family, before we actually start the service, just want to say to Veronica and Larry, we love you. We loved your son. And also to the siblings, and Natasha and Marianne and so many children here, and you know, all the little nephews and nieces. We just want to tell you, the people that are here, you know, they might, that they love you and they're here to support you in this difficult time. Let's pray. If we could just please bow our heads. Heavenly Father, we acknowledge your presence here and come before your throne this morning as family and friends of Mark. We're here because we love him and we miss him. And we want to cherish our memories of him. We want to honor his life and honor him and support one another as we grieve his passing. A passing from life here with us to everlasting life with the Lord. Father, we thank you. You are a God of mercy who promises to comfort us, particularly when we lose our loved ones. So in these moments now and in the weeks and months ahead, please continue to bring comfort and mercy to us as we remember and share fondly all that Mark was to us. In the name of Jesus, we pray. There's a beautiful hymn that the family has chosen. It's a hymn that's so familiar with it. It's a beautiful hymn, The Old Rugged Cross.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love
just like to call forward Jarvis on behalf of the family to share Mark's eulogy.
Hello everyone, my name's Jarvis and I'm a cousin of Waller, but I consider myself a brother, and you know, Before I read this, I just want to pay my respects to you, Auntie Veronica, and Uncle Larry, James, Natasha and Mary, you know. Much love. Yeah. We are here today to farewell Mark Matthew Briggs, beloved son of Veronica Briggs and Larry McCarthy. Mark, affectionately known as Waller, was born in Shepparton Hospital on the 15th of June, 1989. The second eldest of four children, he was a much-loved brother of James, Natasha and Mary Ann. A loving father to Jarawa, 8, and Malia, 2. Uncle of Jatalia, Jaquil, Nevaeh, and Sophia. And a much-loved cousin and nephew to all his extended family. Mark was a beautiful baby, born with a murmur on his heart. This condition did not stop Mark. He was always full of energy and brought so much joy to Veronica and Larry and his siblings. When Mark was old enough, he attended Save the Children's Kindergarten. It didn't take him long to make some friends in the sandbox. This is who Mark was. He had an energy and a smile that easily drew people to him. Mark's Auntie Sonia recalls, when Mark was a baby in his walkie, his pop buddy, Uncle Buddy, picked him up. Mark was so excited to be with his pop. When pop put him back down in the walkie, he screamed and cried and held his breath until he fainted. Auntie Sonia had to run outside and get Uncle Bud, pop, to come back inside. When Uncle Bud picked him back up, pop, he clung to his neck and wouldn't let go. He wouldn't let Uncle Bud put him down. Uncle Bud couldn't leave Mark until he settled down. Mark went on to attend Gary Street Primary School. This is when his love for football started. He started playing football for Rumbalara. He had a passion for footy and was determined and committed to make himself a better player. He was always at training. He even saved up money to get himself a bike so that he could get fit. He had a fantastic footy career. His family loved to watch him play. Mark was a natural. He was a very sporty. He loved being active. He also played cricket and he was a mad St Kilda fan. Mark loved to be with his family. He loved hanging out with his cousins and swimming down the river. He loved fishing and camping and grubbing. He loved to drive around with his pop, Uncle Buddy. He idolised him. Always looked up to him as a little boy. Mark would wake up early with the birds, just like Pop, Uncle Bud. Pop also taught him to drive. It was a manual ute. You just had to hop in, hold on, and hope for the best. You know, I recall, you know, one time when, you know, Waller was about 6 or 7 and Uncle Bud lived in 52 Fay Street, Immanuel Lorraine, and, you know, Waller loved football that much, you know, he wouldn't take his football boots off. You know, he had these footy boots on and they wasn't just the grass cats, he had the screw-in studs and, you know, we're walking, we're going for a mission, me and the other boys, and Waller was trying to follow us and we said, cuz, you can't follow us in them football boots, bros. You know, sparks were flying off the cement and cuz, you gotta go back home. No, but yeah, there was other stories where we all used to sneak out to the golf course and, you know, we go and collect all the golf balls up and, you know, we get all the golf balls and we try to sell them back to the golfers or sell them back to our neighbours. And this one day we're all out there collecting all these golf balls and, you know, we seen Uncle Bud's bus pull up. We drop the golf balls and we hit the roads, you know. We're gone. Yeah. Yeah, but, You know, also Mark and his cousins. Us boys, you know, we'd also sneak into the circuses, rake up for the circuses, or, you know, get shouted, and we'd go to these circuses, and, you know, we'd rock up, we'd take a feed there, and, yeah, that was a really special memory that I hold, and, yeah. You know, we'd ask the circuses and the chef shows and stuff like that to try to get odd jobs here and there, and, yeah. You know, Waller and the boys too, you'd also walk around the neighbourhood, you know, asking people if you could, you know, we'd knock on the doors and we'd say, can we wash your car for $2, you know, until we could rake up enough to get to the cinemas and, that's right, straight from the bottom to the top, yeah. You know, and when we get enough for all of us, we'd go to the cinemas and, you know, have a good night. Yeah, when Mark was 15 or so, you know, Mark Waller got a job at a clothing store called Alley Cat. He was so proud of himself. He loved working there. He worked there for a few years and also done some labour jobs. Pop, Uncle Bud, took Mark and his cousins to tomato picking in Shepparton, Robinvale, Burnsdale and Lake Entrance, you know, to earn a few odd dollars here and there. Now I remember another quick story. Now I remember one time we used to walk around, you know, the North End, and we look for plum trees, and we, you know, me and one of the other brothers come across this plum tree. Mapped them out, you know. And the plums on this tree were that big. I thought, we can't just hit this with our pockets. We gotta go get some plastic bags. And you know, so we quickly went home, got some bags and that, and when we come back around the corner, I looked at the plum tree and it was shaking, you know, and all the leaves were falling out, and I was thinking, who could be in this tree? And I got up there and it was Waller. He cleaned the tree right up, but he still shared the plums, and, you know, Will was right. Yeah. You know, Mark was a family man. He loved his brothers and sisters and his mum and dad unconditionally. He always had his family's back, no matter what. Always honest and loyal, but he was a prankster too. Loved to have a laugh, no torment. His laugh was infectious. He was always smiling. He was well known for his smile and big heart. He was a big kid, loved to play with all the kids and have fun. Mark has two children, Jarawa and Malia. He loved spending time with them kids. When his first son, Jarrell, was born, he was his pride and joy. He wanted to provide for his kids and take care of them. They were the joy of his life. Always made sure his kids were right when he became a dad. He loved to cook, especially Silverside, pasta, and always made sure they knew how much he loved them. Mark was only 31. His life was taken too soon. He was proud of his culture, a good-hearted, kind, sensitive soul. Despite his challenges, he was always happy and was looking forward to a positive future. Another life lost to the Dreamtime far too soon and will be sadly missed by all who knew him. The family wishes to express their heartfelt thanks to all those have given their support, compassion, and love at this difficult time. You know, Mark, you're a yorta-yorta warrior. You know, like you say, aren't a general. Never back down, you know. Never half-stepped. He go all the way. Mark, you will be forever in our hearts, brother. Gone, but never forgotten. Love you, cuz.
There's an opportunity for some testimonials, and family would like to give you that opportunity now. If family or friends would like to come, please come.
What is Mom, Mark Matthew? I'll tell you about the Bible. When Jesus is gunslinging. When Jesus chose him, he chose well to be my son. My good old son. They murdered a general on a golden afternoon. A golden summertime. I'm nothing without him. His brother, his general, he's hardest but that general they playing the soldier. We went to the ocean one time. Gippsland, Tanya's family, my brother's wife, Douglas, took us to the lake's entrance. We were swimming in the sea. And I turned my back for a second. And he was gone. It was the seaweed, he got caught up in the seaweed. He was going that way. I then went to get the towel, get him out. And I saved him, protected him right there, and I said, I'll put his hair up right up from the seaweed. Yeah, but I got right down, he was tangled up in all the seaweed. Yeah. Went for a barbecue. I found him over there, and I had to swim that way, he was in the seaweed. And I dived down, and I put him up by the hair of the head. He clung to me. No tomorrow. He was dreaming for a while, a long time. I saved him. I did save you, son. I did protect you. I saved you, my son. You walked the streets of gold with God. I love you, son. And I'll see you again.
Love you, bros.
Couldn't ask for a better son. He got a lot of love to care for. That's right. Everyone, it's not our breath or breathing, it's his. I'm going to miss him so much. And he said he'd love him to the future. His life still goes on between Carol and Maria. He's got a big family, he's got a lot of love to care for. He's getting to heaven already, he's already there. He's going to be a grandfather as well. He's a man of many colours. A brother, cousin, father, friend, every lover, everything. You know, he brought him up. You know, treat the women, mom, you know, with respect and that. Brought him up with gentlemen. Treat the little girls and treat them as princesses because that's what they are. He had a lot of plans plenty of plans and ideas to make change. He wanted about his family's health. Worried about the children's health. And he wished what to get all the people's health back. That's what he wanted. He wanted to be healthy. And life was too short. And I'll see you again, my son. And I'll see you in the streets of gold. My general was murdered on a golden afternoon. And everyone got to die. And I answered to God. Anything was done in the dark, said in the dark, was seen the light.
My name's David Dryden. I'm a Yorta man, Jardrung Rattery. On behalf of my family, Percy, Judy, Stanley, my thoughts are with everybody here today. Last time I seen Waller was at Ravenhall, and was doing some work in there, and he was happy to see me. As other people were just saying there, he was full of big smiles and really happy. We talked about him. He had a motorcycle, a Harley Davidson, I think he said he had, and he was going to go for a ride one day when he either got that one back or he bought another one. Beautiful man. Had your back anytime you needed it, and what we say when you ride a motorcycle is shiny side up, son. Yeah, shiny side up. So yeah, gonna be forever missed. And I got a few of these pamphlets that we have when we come here, and I look over them sometimes. And some people that are gone, beautiful people. Yeah, so that'll do. Thank you.
Family have put together no doubt it'll be a beautiful presentation of memories. A lot of memories, and as Jarvis said, there's as he shared, you may not get to share them today, but I just encourage us, as you look through the family presentation, those things that bring to mind, please share those memories, those moments that the family may not know of, particularly as children, and we'll watch that slideshow now.
Riding on the until you go, and I'll be right there by your side. And even then, whisper the wind, and she will carry up your right. I hear all the people of the world, in one bird's lonely cry. See them trying every way they know how to make their spirit fly. Can't you see him? He's down on the ground. He's a broken wing, looking all around. That's the way it's gonna be, little darling. You go riding on the horses, yeah, yeah. Way up in the sky, little darling. Oh, and if you fall, pick you up, pick you up. That's the way it's gonna be, little darling. You go riding on the horses, yeah, yeah. Way up in the sky, little darling. And if you fall, pick you up, pick you up.
That's the way it's gonna be, little darling. You go riding on the horses, yeah,
pick yeah.
Way up the sky, little darling.
Don't you worry about it, baby.
And if you fall, I'll pick you up.
Many a tear has to fall over the soul. It's all in the game, child. It's all in the wonderful game.
All right.
Here we know as love. You had words with him, and your future's looking dim. But these things your heart rise above. Once in a while, he won't call. He won't call. But I heard you. It's all in the game. Soon he will be there with a small bouquet. He will. And she will kiss your lips. You and just like that, touch you. Yeah, and your heart will, yeah, fly. job was looking. Don't you worry about it. These things, your heart, these things, rise above. Once in a while, he won't call. But you gotta be patient. Soon he will be there with a small bouquet. And he will kiss your lips. He'll caress your waiting fingertips. Your heart will fly away. Listen. He will kiss your lips. And touch you. And you will feel like gonna fly.
Well, what a beautiful presentation of family, eh? Some photos and some beautiful memories. Just want to share some things. And for Ron and Larry and all the family, and particularly for all of us. There's a story in the Bible, in John 11. I just want to read it. It's really quickly. Now, there's this lady, Martha, and it reads this way. Then Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went and met him. But Mary sat still in the house. Mary was still in the house because her brother had passed away. Then said Martha unto Jesus, Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died. But I know even now, whatsoever you will ask of God, God will give it to thee. And Jesus said unto her, thy brother shall rise again. And Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. And Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? And Martha said this amazing thing. She said, yea, Lord, I believe that thou art the Christ, the Son of God, which has come into the world. The book of Romans says, knowing all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loves us. For I'm convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. And he says this, and he's right at the end. God says, and God shall wipe away all tears from the eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither there shall be any more pain, for the things, former things have passed away. And I was really heartened to hear Sister Veronica, you know, and believing that her son is working the streets of gold. And many of us heard the song that Uncle Manuel sang in the sweet by and by. There's a land that is afar. And in that song, he says there's only one way that we reach that faraway land. It says, by faith. Amen. By faith. And it doesn't say you work for it. It doesn't say that you got to be good enough. It doesn't say that you need to be rich enough. It doesn't need to say anything, but if you would only believe, all things are possible. And that's the possible that I believe with Mark today. I've seen him grow as a boy. And I'm really saddened today. But I have a hope. That same hope that his mother has. That he's gone home. That he's gone home, and we look at a farewell, but we never consider the homecoming. As my Uncle Manuel sang that song many a times, on the sweet by and by, where family are waiting on that beautiful shore. If I could ask Ryan and the pallbearers to come, please. And I just want to add and say to Larry and Veronica and all the family, I want to say that everybody here are here today because they loved your son, but they're here because they love you. And I just want to encourage everybody that not just for today, but just hold up a little bit. We've got to hold up. The family's going to need your support. Not only today, but the days and the weeks and the months of the year and years ahead. So, Heavenly Father, as we live this place, Father, I just pray for the family, for your God, divine presence to be with them. Father, your word declares that you're the God of all comfort. And Father, I pray for that comfort for the family, for the peace that surpasses all understanding. May your covenant and love just bind them together, Father. Lord, in the year, the months and those times ahead, Father, that you would provide every provision and need. And Father, I thank you for each and every person that made this journey to be with the family today. Lord, I pray that you grant them traveling mercies home. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Peter, please.
Take me way back. I'm gonna go.